Hello students, we are going to discuss about combustion of solid, liquid and gas fuel problems. Natural gas contains 85% methane and 15% ethane by volume. Calculate the GHV of this fuel in kilojoule per kg from the standard heat of combustion of methane and ethane. CH4 plus 2O2 gives CO2 plus 2H2O. Standard heat of combustion value minus 802.62 kilojoule per mole. So another reaction, C2H6 plus 3.5O2 gives 2CO2 plus 3H2O. Standard heat of combustion data minus 1428.64 kilojoule per mole. Latent heat of water vapor at 298 Kelvin, 2442.5 kilojoule per kg. Are you clear on that? Okay. Objective of this problem, determine GHV of this fuel in kilojoule per kg from standard heat of combustion of methane or ethane. Are you clear on that? Okay. So this problem differ from previous problems. So why? Because so GHV values are calculated from standard heat of combustion of given component. Are you clear on that? Okay. So solution of this problem, basis. So 1 mole of natural gas. So why? Because so the data are given kilojoule per mole. For this reason, you should take 1 mole of natural gas. Data mole percentage of methane 85%. Mole percentage of ethane 15%. So why? Because the problem is given. So all these component percentages are by volume. So we know the concept, volume percentage is equal to mole percentage. For this reason, you should take mole percentage of methane and mole percentage of ethane, that is equal to volume percentage of methane and volume percentage of ethane. Are you clear on that? Okay. Lambda value is also given. Lambda is equal to 2442.5 kilojoule per kg. Are you clear on that? Okay. Objective of this problem, GHV in terms of kilojoule per kg. GHV is nothing but cross heating value. We have two expression. Methane reacts with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water. Standard heat of combustion value minus 802.62. So another reaction, ethane reacts with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water. Standard heat of combustion minus 1428.64. Number of moles of methane, number of moles of ethane should be taken from composition values. Composition of methane and composition of ethane given in this problem in terms of volume percentage or mole percentage. So percentages are directly taken as number of moles, but this problem the basis of 1 mole. For this reason, you should take number of moles of methane is equal to 0.85 mole, number of moles of ethane is equal to 0.15 mole. Total moles is equal to 1 mole. Are you clear on that? Okay. So for this problem, we want to calculate cross-heating value or cross-calorific value. We don't know the value of NCV or NHV. What it is here? So the NCV values are calculated from standard heat of combustion value. Standard heat of combustion data are available in this problem. You should take that value. First you determine NCV value. So formula for NCV, NCV is equal to summation of Ni into minus delta of the C0i. Are you clear on that? Okay. So this is the relationship between standard heat of combustion and net calorific value. Are you clear on that? Okay. So here we have two components. So change the formula, N of CH4 into standard heat of combustion of CH4 plus N of ethane into standard heat of combustion of ethane. So here number of moles of methane, standard heat of combustion of methane, number of moles of ethane, standard heat of combustion of ethane, all these data are known. Substitute here, first find out net calorific value or net heating value, 896.52 kilojoule per mole. We have two expressions, methane and ethane react with oxygen to produce combustion product. like carbon dioxide and water are clear and okay. From reaction 1, as per the reaction, 1 mole of methane to produce 2 mole of water. As per the problem, 0.85 mole of methane is reacted mean, how much mole of water is produced? 0.85 into 2 divided by 1, 1.7 mole water is produced by reaction 1. So, from reaction 2, 1 mole of methane to produce 3 mole of water as per the reaction. As per the problem, 0.15 mole of methane to produce how much mole of water? 3 into 0.15 divided by 1, that is equal to 0.45 times of mole. This is reaction number 2. Are you clear on that? Okay. 0.45 moles of water produced by reaction 2. Total water produced, that is small m, is equal to water produced by reaction 1 plus water produced by reaction 2. 1.7 plus 0.45, that is equal to 2.15 times of mole. Are you clear on that? Okay. So we want in terms of kg, what do you do here? Use the relation number of moles into weight. Are you clear on that? Okay. So here weight is equal to number of moles into molecular weight. Are you clear on that? Okay. So number of moles here 2.15, molecular weight of which component? Water. So that is 80. 2.15 into 80, this is equal to 38.7 gram. We want in terms of kg. What did you hear? Use the relation. 1000 gram is equal to 1 kg. Are you clear on that? Okay. So from that, so 1 gram is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 kg. Are you clear on that? Okay. So finally we get total water produced, m is equal to 38.7 into 10 to the power of minus 3 kg. Are you clear on that? Okay. Objective of this problem, find out GCV value. GCV is equal to NCV plus M lambda. NCV, M lambda values are known. Substitute here, find out GCV, 991.04 kilojoule per mole. We want in terms of kilojoule per kilomole. What do you do here? Mole is converted into kilomole. 1 mole is equal to 10 to the minus 3 kilomole. So here, mole is a denominator. 10 to the minus 3 kilomole is a denominator side. This is goes to numerator. Finally, we get GCV is equal to 991.04 into 10 to the 3 kilojoule per kilomole. Are you clear on that? Okay. So next we want in terms of kg, the GCV value. What did you hear? GCV is equal to 991.04 into 10 to the 3 divided by molecular weight. But here we have more than one component in this problem. Are you clear on that? Okay. So what do you do here? Instead of molecular weight, we should take average molecular weight. Are you clear on that? Okay. So M average is equal to summation of Mi into Xi. We have two components, XCH4 into MCH4 plus XEthane into MEthane. So what is X value? X is the mole fraction. So we want mole fraction of methane and mole fraction of ethane. Mole fraction formula, number of moles of methane by total mole. Number of moles of methane 0.85, total mole 1. 0.85 divided by 1 is equal to mole fraction of methane. Are you clear on that? Okay. So similarly, mole fraction of ethane, number of moles of ethane divided by total mole. Number of moles of ethane 0.15. Total mole 1. Finally, we get mole fraction of ethane, that is equal to 0.15. Are you clear on that? Okay. So now we are going to calculate average molecular weight. Mole fraction of methane 0.85. This is calculated value. Molecular weight of methane 16. Molecular weight is nothing but summation of the atomic weight of the component. Plus mole fraction of ethane 0.15, this is also calculated value. Molecular weight of ethane, that is 30. Finally we get average molecular weight 18.1 kg per kilomole. GCV is equal to 991.04 into 10 to the 3 divided by average molecular weight. Average molecular weight here calculated value, that is equal to 18.1. Divide these two values. Finally, we get GCV is equal to 54753.6 kilojoule per kg per clear. Okay, thank you for your attention.